I welcome you all to this problem solution series in digital electronics. I am solving the problems from the book Digital Design by Maurice Mann and Michael Cilletti, 4th edition. So in this video, I am solving the problem number 6.22 from the chapter number 6. The problem is, for the circuit of figure 6.28, we will see this figure, okay, from the book, and give 4 alternatives for a mode 12 counter. That means we have to design a mode 12 counter, okay, in 4 different ways. Here we have the 4 given conditions. Okay, so the first condition is using an AND gate and the load input. Second condition is using the output carry. That means we have to now do some modification in the block diagram using this output carry so that it becomes a mode 12 counter. And in the third case, using NAND gate and a asynchronous clear input, we have to make this mode 12 counter. And in the fourth case, using load input and the bubble input NOR gate. Okay, so we have to consider here the bubble input NOR gate. So before solving the problem, let us go to our this figure 6.28, and from that let us understand what are the load input, carry output, and then we have to see the clear input. Okay, so this is figure 6.28. So it is a 4-bit binary counter with parallel load. So this is a 4th edition book. Okay, in the 5th edition book, you will get this is figure 6.14. In this figure, we can see that this count out, C out is the carry output. So this carry output is dependent on this A3, A2, A1, and A0. And this last input is, this one is the multiplication between this count and this load complement. Okay, so if count is 1 and load is 0, then this output will be 1. Okay, then only this carry output will be 1. So this load input is applied to all the AND gates with each one of the inputs. Okay, so to understand the operation of the circuit, let us see this table. So this is the function table of the counter of figure 6.28. Whenever we have load is equal to 1 and irrespective of the count input, it will load all the inputs. That means whatever be the values in the I0, I1, I2 and I3, it will be loaded into the register. Okay, whenever we have load is equal to 0 and count equal to 1, this count next binary state. That means the output of the counter will be incremented by 1. And when we have load is equal to 0 and count is 0, both are 0 and 0, we'll have no change. Okay, now let us proceed to the solution. So in the first part of the problem, we have to use the block diagram of figure 6.28 and we have to use the AND gate load input. Okay, now let us draw the block diagram first. Okay, so suppose this is figure 6.28. In the 5th edition book, this will be 6.14. Okay, suppose inside this block, we have this circuit of figure 6.28, that is 4-bit counter. So here we'll have one count input, second one will have load input, then we have a clock input, okay, and we have another clear input. We have a bubble here. Whenever we have an active low, that means whenever there is a 1 to 0 transition, this all this output of this flip-flops will be reset. And here we'll have 4 outputs. So here we'll have one carry output. This carry output, suppose C underscore out. This carry output will be 1 whenever we'll have the load is equal to 0 and count equal to 1 and all the 4 outputs are 1. Here also we'll have 4 inputs. Suppose this is 1 input, 2 input, 3 input, and suppose these are I3, I2, I1 and I0. Okay, these are the 4 inputs. Let us sort all these inputs and apply here a logic 0. Whenever we have load equal to 1, okay, all these 4 inputs are 0 here we have applied. That will load, whenever we have load is equal to 1, all this logic 0 input will be applied to this register. Okay, so here we have 4 outputs, A3, A2, A1, A0. Okay, these are the 4 outputs. Now, in the first case, we have to use an AND gate and load input to make it mode 12 counter. So, we know that for a mode 12 counter, we'll have 12 distinct states. So, let me write down here. For mode 12 counter, there are 12 stable states. Okay, that is suppose from 0 up to 11, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to 11. Okay, that means including 0 will have 12 number of states. Now, whenever we have 11, okay, 11 means 1, 0, 1, 1. And this 0 means 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay, so from 0 to 11, we have to count. Okay, so what we have to do? Whenever we have 11, we have to go back to 0 because it is a mode 12 counter we have to design. So whenever we have 1, 0, 1, 1 at these outputs, what we have to do? We have to make this load high so that all these 0 inputs is entered into the circuit. This circuit will next go to 0, 0, 0, 0. So what we'll do? We will use a AND gate, because in the question it is given that we have to use a AND gate. Okay, and how we connect? So all the 1 values will connect. 1, 0, 1, 1. This is A3, A2, A1 and A0. Okay, so connect from A3, then A1 and A0. Because these are the 1 values here. Okay, so whenever we get 1, 0, 1, 1. Okay, we will get 1 value at this output. Okay, so this 1 should be connected to this load input. So this counter will count from 0000, 0001, and whenever we have 1011, that is whenever we have 11 output, okay, 11 at this output, we will have this AND gate output will be 1, and this is connected to this load input. And here we will keep count is equal to 1 always, and clear is equal to 1 always, so that it is not cleared. Okay, so whenever we have 1 here, this load will be 1. Okay, whenever we have load is equal to 1, this register will be loaded with 0000 because we have applied here a logic 0. So this is the solution of the part A problem of the problem. So therefore, the count sequence will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So after 11, it will go to 000 again because we have made such a mechanism so that whenever we have 11, 1011 here, this load will be 1 and 000 will be loaded. That means after 11, it will go back to 0 and start counting. So now it is becoming a mode 12 counter. Okay, so this one is the solution of the first part of the problem. Now let us go to our second part of the problem. In the second part, we have to do some similar mechanism, but here we are given that we have to use only the output carry. So let me draw the block diagram first. Okay, so in the second part also, here we'll have this figure 6.28. So this figure is 6.14 in the case of fifth edition book. Okay, so this figure is inside this block. Okay, so here we'll have one count in count. So here also we'll make it equal to 1. So here we'll have one load. So here we'll have one clock input. And here we'll have a active low clear input. And here we'll have 4 outputs. 83 82 a1 a0. Okay, and here we'll have one carry output c_out. Okay, this is the carry output, and here we'll have 4 inputs. Here also what we'll do, we'll sort 3 of them. Okay, and what we'll do, this i2 input, this is i2. Okay, this is i3, i2, i1 and i0. So here we'll apply a 1 value, and here we'll apply logic 0. So let me explain this circuit. So this is the design, and as per the question, we have to use the output carry. So what we'll do, we'll connect this output to this load input. That means whenever we have carry out is equal to 1, this load will be 1. Okay, whenever we have load is equal to 1, this value will be loaded into this circuit. That means whenever this load is equal to 1, this logic 0 we have applied here, we have applied logic 1 here. That means we have 0, 1, 0, 0 will be loaded. Will be loaded when C out equal to load equal to 1. Here we have applied 0. these three are zero, okay. And at this I2 input, we have applied logic one, so we'll have 0100 will be loaded. That means we'll have four. So now let us see the count sequence. Whenever we have these outputs are 1111, okay, because we have not connected here this any of these outputs, so only this carry out is connected to this load. Whenever we have carry out is equal to one, that means for making this carry out one, this will be all this will be 1 and 1111. So this load input will be one. So whenever we have load this input equal to one, we'll have 0100 will be loaded into the registers. So here we can see that the count sequence will be, so the count sequence will be is equal to, so here you can see that 0100 it will start from 4. Okay, so 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14 and 15. So whenever we will have this 15 at this output, this carry output will be 1. Okay, so that will make this load equal to 1, and when we have load equal to 1, this value will be again inserted. That means it will go back to 4 value. Okay, that means from starting from 4 it will count up to 15. So here we'll have 12 count. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 and 12 count. Okay, so this is a mod 12 counter. Okay, so second part of the problem is solved now. So let us go to our third part of the problem. So in the third part of the problem, we have to use a NAND gate and an asynchronous clear input. Now we have to use this asynchronous clear input and a NAND gate. So first of all, let me draw the circuit and then I will explain. Okay, so here also we'll have a block diagram. Okay, figure 6.28. So here we'll have one count. So in the previous case also, this count is equal to 1 and clear is equal to 1. Whenever clear is equal to 0, this flip-flop will be reset. Okay, so the complete circuit will be this one. Whenever we have to make this clear is equal to 1 and count equal to 1. Okay, for making this mod 12 counter. Now in the third case, we have got this figure. So count equal to 1, here it will be. And we'll make always load equal to 0. And here we'll apply a clock input, clock, okay, and here we'll have a active low clear input. Here we'll have one carry out, so here we have four outputs, A3, A2, A1, A0. Here we have four inputs. So here we have I3, I2, I1 and I0. These are the four inputs. We have to do some mechanism using a NAND gate and clear input so that it becomes a mod 12 counter. We will sort all these four inputs and apply logic 0 here. That means whenever this load will be equal to 1, this value will, 0 value will be loaded into this circuit. But here we have applied load is equal to 0 always. Okay, so leave about this part of the problem. In this circuit, to make it mod 12 counter, that means we have to clear whenever we have 12 here. We have to count up to 11 from starting from 0. So whenever we have 12 at this output, this clear should be low. That means we'll use here a NAND gate and connect the output of this NAND gate to this clear input. Okay, so whenever we have 0 at this output, this clear will be have an active low signal. That is, previously it was 1, it will be transiting to 0. There will be a transition to 0. So this clear will reset all this output or clear all this output to 0000. Now we have to give the input. We have to connect from this 8 and this input is 4. So 8 plus 4, 12. Whenever we have both this 1, 1, then only this NAND gate will have a 0 output. So whenever we have 1100, this NAND gate output will be 0 and this clear will be activated. Okay, that means this output of this circuit will be go to 0000. Therefore, the count sequence will be, therefore the count sequence will be 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11. So whenever it goes to 12, it will be, this circuit will be reset, or it will be cleared to 000. Whenever we have 12 here, so it will go to 0000. That means after this 11, we will have this 0 again. So here we'll have 12 count states. Okay, so this is a mod 12 counter now. Okay, now let us go to our fourth part of the problem. In the fourth part of the problem, we have to use a load input and bubble input NOR gate. Okay, so here we have to understand that this bubble input NOR gate is nothing but a AND gate. Okay, so when we'll see the operation of this bubble input NOR gate, this is nothing but an AND gate. So here also in this first case, we have a load input and AND gate. Here also we have load input and bubble input NOR gate. Okay, that means this circuit will be similar to this circuit, only the AND gate will be replaced with a bubble input NOR gate. Okay, so let me draw it quickly. So here we also, we'll have a block diagram, figure 6.28. This figure will be inside this block. Okay, so here we'll have count, here we'll have load, so here we'll have a clock input, here we'll have an active low clear input, here we'll have carry output. Okay, this is C out, C underscore out means carry output. Okay, so here we'll have these four outputs. They are A3, A2, A1, A0. Here we'll have four inputs. I3, I2, I1, I0. Okay, these are the four inputs. So we have to draw the similar diagram as the in the first case, because we have to replace this AND gate with a bubble input NOR gate. So we have to make this count equal to 1 and clear equal to 1 always. And we will apply here logic 0, count equal to 1 and clear equal to 1. And here we'll apply logic 0. We'll sort all the inputs. And here we'll apply logic 0. And here we'll now use a inverted or bubble input NOR gate. Okay, so this output will be connected to this load input, similar to the previous case. Okay, here also we have connected this output to this load input. So now we have to replace this AND gate with a bubble input NOR gate. The connections will be similar from A3, A1 and A0. This is a bubble input NOR gate. So here we have three bubbles for all the three inputs. Okay, and the connections will be from A3, then A1 and A0. Okay, so these are the three bubble input and this is a bubble input NOR gate. Okay, and the output of this NOR gate is connected to this load. So the count sequence of the circuit will be, therefore, the count sequence will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. And after 11, this will be 1. Okay, load will be 1. And this 0 value will be loaded into this resistors, internal resistors. Okay, so this is the solution of the problem number 6.22 from the chapter number 6. Thank you for watching. If you have any question, please put it in the comment section below. Also like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.